On July 1st, 2002, a BTC2937 Tupolev-154 type, carrying a total of 69 passengers and crew, departed from Moscow, Russia, and headed for Barcelona, Spain. The DHL611, Boeing 757 type, with two pilots aboard, departed from Bergamo, Italy, and was heading for Brussels, Belgium. The flight paths of DHL611 and BTC2937 crossed at the southernmost end of Germany, and the flight zone was covered by Zurich ACC in Switzerland. Originally, two controllers were working, but because the traffic was very low, one controller left the control room to take a break, and only the other one stayed in the control room. DHL611 contacted Zurich ACC on frequency 128.05, and the altitude at that time was flight level 260. DHL611 asked the controller to climb to flight level 360. The controller approved this. DHL611 has reached flight level 360. AEF-1135, which was not scheduled, suddenly called the controller on the terminal frequency 119.92, requested to land at Friedrichshafen International Airport. BTC-2937 contacted Zurich ACC on frequency 128.05. At this time, the altitude of BTC-2937 was at flight level 360. One controller remaining in the control room started to control the ACC area with the left console and the approach control with the right console. The controller made a phone call to the Friedrichshafen Tower to inform the AEF-1135's landing information. However, due to the technical work of the Zurich ACC telephone system, the controller was unable to contact the Friedrichshafen Control Tower. The controller did not notice that DHL611 and BTC2937 were heading to the same point at the same altitude. The controller tried to contact the Friedrichshafen Tower several times again. However, no contact was reached and the controller wasted time worrying about this simple task. Controller of a nearby control facility, UAC Karlsruhe, witnessed the collision warning of the two aircraft on the control radar and tried to inform the Zurich ACC by making several phone calls. However, contact was not possible due to a technical problem of the telephone system, and the Zurich ACC controller did not report it to a nearby control facility, even though he had already known about it. Besides, that night, even the control radar system was in backup mode due to maintenance problems. Therefore, the ground-based radar alert system, STCA, short-term conflict alert, was not operated. This STCA is a device that generates visual and audible warnings when the threat of collision between aircraft is detected through the control radar. DHL611 and BTC2937 each received TCAS TA at the same time. At this point, the controller noticed that the two aircraft were approaching each other. So the controller instructed BTC2937 to expedite descent to flight level 350. BTC2937 received TCAS RA alert. Climb, climb. At the same time, DHL611 received the TCAS RA, descend, descend. DHL611 started to descend. The controller instructed BTC2937 to expedite descent to flight level 350 once again, and issued traffic information for DHL611. However, at that time, the controller incorrectly informed BTC2937 that DHL611 was at 2 o'clock, but it was actually at 10 o'clock. Confused as the controller's instruction and TCAS warning contradict each other, BTC2937 decided to trust the controller's instruction and continued descending. The controller detected BTC2937 descending through radar. Thus, he misunderstood that the aircraft had escaped the risk of collision and moved to the right to control AEF-1135, who called the controller twice. DHL-611 received a TCAS RA, increased descent. DHL611 informed the controller that it is starting the TCAS descent. However, the controller did not notice this because the calls of AEF-1135 were sent out at the same time. BTC-2937 received TCAS RA, increase climb. Waitley, BTC-2937 found DHL-611 and attempted to climb. However, two aircraft that were heading to the same point with the same altitude eventually collided in the air. We can see this tragic aerial crash as the result of a series of bad luck. Was that bad luck just a joke of fate that couldn't be avoided? Of course, various complex factors such as the pilot's aspect and the maintenance aspect will play a role in this accident. However, in this video, we will focus on the air traffic control side. Before that, let's take a quick look at the TCAS, which sent the pilots a warning at a critical moment.
TCAS stands for Traffic Alert and Collision Avoidance System. It does not depend on the ground-based navigation system. TCAS is the installed equipment on the aircraft. By using the transponder, aircraft can send out the interrogation signal to the near aircraft and self-analyze the range, altitude, and bearing of them by response signal. Through that information, it recognizes aircraft at risk of collision and warns the pilot. For example, when two different aircraft equipped with TCAS approach, avoidance coordination is automatically made between the two aircraft. And TCAS instructs one aircraft to descend and another aircraft to climb. A traffic advisory is called TA, and when the intruder aircraft enters the expected collision area about 20 to 48 seconds before, the symbol of the intruder aircraft is changed to amber on the cockpit display, and a voice alarm of
traffic, traffic
sounds. The resolution advisory is called RA, and it is an alarm that occurs when intruder aircraft enter the expected collision area about 15 to 35 seconds before. The intruder aircraft symbol turns red, and voice alerts such as
climb, climb,
and
descent, descent
are activated for avoidance maneuvers. Both DHL-611 and BTC-2937 appearing in this accident were aircraft equipped with TCAS. As a result, when the two aircraft were close to each other less than a certain distance, TCAS sent a TA signal followed by an RA signal to the two aircraft. Now let's go back to the date of the accident. If a single situation was different, how different would the accidents of that day be?
1. What if the controller did not give contrary instructions to TCAS? The controller noticed later that DHL-611 and BTC-2937 were located on the converging course at the same altitude. He immediately ordered BTC-2937 the expedite descent to flight level 350. However, after that, BTC-2937 received the RA climb alert and immediately reported it to the controller. Soon after, DHL-611 also informed the controller that he had received the TCAS descent alert. The controller immediately corrected his instructions and told DHL-611 and BTC-2937 to implement the TCAS instructions. The controller also informed DHL-611 that another aircraft at the 2 o'clock position will TCAS climb. The BTC-2937 aircraft has been issued information that another aircraft at the 10 o'clock position will TCAS descend. At that time, AEF-1135 was trying to call the controller on the terminal frequency several times. The controller immediately moved to the right and just said standby to AEF-1135 and focusing on the ACC frequency. If it had been delayed a little, an air collision would have occurred. However, each pilot notified the controller as soon as they received a TCAS alert. As a result, the controller also corrected his instructions, and consequently the two aircraft were able to avoid the worst situation.
When this accident happened, DHL-611 followed the FAA regulation standard. For this reason, as soon as the TCAS alarm sounded, it was possible to descend according to the TCAS instruction. But the Russian regulation for BTC-2937 leaves the pilot to choose which instruction to follow when the TCAS alarm and the controller's instructions differ. After this incident, ICAO and FAA stipulated a common rule to prioritize TCAS alerts over air traffic controller's instructions when receiving TCAS RA alerts. This means that the controller should not give contrary instructions to the RA warning when the pilot is implementing the RA warning. Also, since the control unit cannot know the TA or RA generated by the aircraft, there is a possibility that the controller will give contradictory instructions that confuse the pilot. Therefore, the pilot must report the avoidance maneuver by TCAS RA alarm to the control unit.
2. What if two controllers were together in the control room? At night with very low traffic, there is a controller alone in the control room, but the unscheduled aircraft AEF-1135 contacted with approach frequency. The controller called to inform about this aircraft to the Friedrichshafen Tower, but there was no answer. The telephone system didn't work properly due to technical work. Though feeling sorry, the controller called his colleague. Soon, the colleague tried to contact Friedrichshafen Tower and took exclusive responsibility for controlling AEF-1135. The other controller therefore could focus on ACC control. The controller who was in charge of ACC control realized that the two aircraft were heading to the same spot at the same altitude. By instructing climb and descent for each aircraft, he could eliminate the risk factors in advance.
Unstable devices and contact from unscheduled aircraft. They can be enough reasons to call for help from the colleague. Out of the control room does not mean that the time is just for the rest. That means standby position. You must be aware that the controller always needs to be prepared. If two controllers were in charge of each control seat, that day must be a normal day as usual.
3. What if handling technical work was different? Tonight, the radar system is operated in backup mode. The controller was prepared mentally for it, so he tried to give more attention to the traffic separation. Suddenly, the unscheduled aircraft AEF-1135 requested the landing. He tried to call the Friedrichshafen control tower but couldn't reach it. This was due to the technical work with the telephone system. However, the controller was aware of the maintenance of the telephone system for tonight. So, he had prepared the secondary communication device with help from the mechanic earlier. Of course, he had already let other control units to use the temporary ways for the telephone system in case the main system does not work. Also, he had checked if the secondary devices work. He calmly contacted the Friedrichshafen control tower using the secondary devices. So the controller doesn't need to waste his time or be busy moving his chair left and right to deal with the situation.
Any device essential for coordination among control units or affecting the control directly should be prepared with the secondary system in advance, despite the maintenance work to disregard any influence on the control task. Also, the secondary system needs to be checked by the controller earlier if it does work properly, and the information on the change of the temporary system has to be informed to control units in advance. If this simple task is done perfectly, there is no way that the maintenance work interrupts your control task.
4. What if there had been one more check and one more word? When there was contact from BTC2937, the controller realized that it is at the same altitude as DHL611. The controller instructed BTC2937 to descend before two aircraft become closer, and traffic information on DHL611 had been issued together. Not only the controller instructed altitude climb to DHL611, but also issued the information on BTC2937. In addition, he did not forget to check if two aircraft reached at the altitude that he each instructed. So, two pilots could check each position and safely cross each other.
If the controller instructed descent and climb to both of each aircraft. If he issued the information on traffic information to each. If he separated two aircraft just a few seconds earlier. And if he monitored if two aircraft completely followed the instructions, what would happen? Sometimes, a simple act can lead to a completely different result. The controller should judge fast what is more urgent and the priority of the task, and should make the safest action that can be done at every moment.
What if any one of these assumptions were real? Who would expect a real accident? However, if one is not well trained with attitude and practice on how to deal with situations and tasks, one will never acquire skill at the time when an urgent situation comes. Any trivial thought and action you make in the control room can be either the cause or prevention of an accident. ATC for you.